Egypt is a natural and traditional partner of the European Union and one of its most important neighbors. And this is shown by the relevance of our cooperation and the figures of our numbers of our assistance. Currently, we have committed in grants, and this is important to mention because these are not loans, they are grants, more than 1.1 billion of euros that have served, amongst other things, to leverage more than 2.3 billion of loans from European financial institutions. So our cooperation is diverse and rich. It ranges from education to water, from energy to culture, or from SMEs to vocational training. We work with a variety of partners, the government, of course, which is the main partner when implementing our cooperation, but as well with other development partners, such as implementing agencies of the member states of the European Union, and of course with NGOs. Only in 2015, we did commit an extra 140 million in grants to the benefit of the Egyptian population. And in 2016, we're expecting to do a lot more.
We at the Human and Social Development section of the EU delegation to Egypt work on a wide range of sectors that are at the core of Egypt's socioeconomic development. One of them is the work through the World Food Programme. The project is entitled Enhancing Access of Children to Education and Fighting Child Labour. Our goal is to provide school feeding for children in remote rural areas and impoverished areas, and particularly we put the focus on access of girls to schools. We will work with community schools, and we also provide the household heads, and particularly women, with food and other commodities baskets to sustain the livelihoods, but also with training on how to generate their own revenues and thereby hopefully lift themselves out of poverty.
The European Union in Egypt supports gender equality and women empowerment. Under EU-funded projects, women are politically and economically empowered. In terms of economic development and economic empowerment, EU funding provides support to women to develop their skills in order to be able to open up new businesses. And the European Union also provides loans in order to provide the financial capital for these women to start their business and generate income.
طبعاً أخذت كارد ب200 رحت جبت بط كبر طبعاً في الأول وبحته وجبت غيره بس وخلال أسبوع كسبت 70 جنيه في 15 بطة
أنا فتحت المشروع ده جديد يعني أول مرة أفتحه فتحته بمبلغ قليل يعني جبت شويه حلاوه قليلين بس مع الوقت يعني كل ما راح اكبر كل ما راح اكبره وبعد كده اخذت كارد من الصندوق جبت منها يعني طلبات وكل ما راح اوسع عشان ايه محتاجين يعني عشان اخواتي يتعلموا وبي يعني طبعا شويه بساعدهم يعني فلوس بتدخل لنا من الحلاوه دي بتساعدنا بصرف على اخواتي عشان اخواتهم يتعلموا ويروحوا كليه
As regards migration, the European Union in the past has focused on protecting refugees in Egypt and has implemented a project in cooperation with the International Organization for Migration, IOM, in support of refugee protection.
I've been in Cairo for about 5 to 6 years. I've been working as an interpreter now for about 12 years. And sometimes we face difficulties in this kind of field. I also have been doing a lot of things that are not related to interpreting. As a social worker, sometimes I get involved in interpreting even when I'm not supposed to. But all of it, I have done a lot which has given me a lot of experiences for interpreting.
We have to acknowledge that Egypt is a country of transit, departure, as well as destination. The European Union is committed to address all these three elements, particularly by addressing development issues in the areas prone to migration as well as working on the protection of refugees located in Egypt.
We also work directly through the government. One example is the Support to Rural Development Program, the SRDP.
أنا الأول ما كنتش بعرف حاجة عن تحليل التربة ده. ثانياً هو كنت أسأل عنه مكلف جداً. فلما جاء المشروع الاتحاد الأوروبي عمل لنا تحليل التربة وجابوا لنا النتيجة طلعت الأرض فيها نسبة ملوحة عالية فنزلوا لنا جبس زراعي استخدمناه للأرض وقلل نسبة الملوحة جداً في الأرض.
We are covering a wide range of support to the different economic areas of Egypt, like water, energy, and transport. This assistance covers very important areas for the development of Egypt, like energy, where Egypt, as we know, faces a certain deficit. But with this programs, we target areas like renewable energy and production of clean energy that will also benefit other aspects like environment. Over 700 million of our support is what we call climate friendly, meaning that they have an impact on the climate change. We are primarily supporting people in Egypt. We are supporting the citizens. We are trying to assist a better quality of life for the citizens in Egypt. One of the strongest assets of Egypt, obviously, needless to say, is its cultural heritage, whether it's pharaonic, Islamic, or modern. And we work on valuing the different art expression that relate to this heritage. And we work also more widely on facilitating the exchanges between both sides, between the European Union on the one hand and Egypt on the other, between artists of both sides, and we work on all the facets of artistic expression.
It's good that EU cooperation here in Egypt is addressing so many needs in the country. I'm particularly proud of the fact that many of our programs have a positive impact on young people. So, for example, we are working with hundreds of thousands of young primary school students, especially girls, to get an education in Upper Egypt. We're working with people in Kafr el-Sheikh on better gas connections. For them, hundreds of thousands of people are benefiting from that. And many young people in the countryside more generally are benefiting from our employment schemes and so on that we are funding here. This is extremely important because Egypt faces great challenges in meeting the needs and the aspirations of its youth. And 2016, of course, is the year of youth in Egypt. So we're proud to be a part of that. We're also very proud to be part of the development of green energy. Wind farms and solar and so forth here in the country, so and many other activities besides. We have a lot of challenges going forward here to make these schemes work in this country, but we're determined to do so because we want to see this country succeed. It's an extremely important partner for the European Union, and we have many, many common challenges and interests that we need to face up to going forward. And so we are looking forward to getting on with the job of cooperation in the longer term here in this country.